So my knowledge base is the ecological restoration, the environmental science of taking a degraded ecosystem and making it into a more functioning ecosystem, whether that's habitat restoration, mine tailings, or in agriculture, they also do restoration. And so I wanted to do, I'm very interested in agriculture and I've worked in agriculture, so I wanted to take the agricultural side of ecological restoration and combine that with the environmental science side and make a more sustainable ecosystem in that way, but that is producing something on the size of land that I have here. My parents were regrading their driveway because the driveway was flooding their basement, and so they dumped a bunch of driveway fill in this pasture here, and my education is in ecological restoration, so I wanted to try and restore the driveway fill to a more functioning ecosystem than just compacted gravel. I know that I need to improve the organic matter, improve the nutrients, improve the root, like the plant roots, and reduce the compaction in that gravel in order for anything to grow. So by using composted horse manure, I'm introducing bacteria, I'm introducing fungus, I'm introducing organic matter, which allows plants and other bacteria and fungus to create relationships and grow that way. I've always been interested in agriculture. I've worked on vegetable farms, I've worked on livestock farms, and I've wanted to be a farmer, but I don't have land. I started looking into flower farms when I started doing this, and I learned that you could create a viable business on 2 acres of, like, that's a big flower farm. That's a lot of flowers, and so you could do that. And I was like, my parents have 10 acres and about 2 acres here in pasture. So if I start small, about a quarter acre is what I've got right now, I could actually make a business and a living from flower farming. And so that seemed like a reasonable and realistic way to start into farming on the land that was available to me through my parents. People want to be able to get into farming, people want to be able to farm, but having access to land is a struggle, whether that's them renting land or, like, people can't afford to buy land. I can't afford to buy land, so I have this great opportunity of my parents' land. For people who are having to rent land or find farmland, that's a serious challenge. And I hear it all the time, whether they want to expand or just get started. Having access to land, I would say, is a huge problem. As an environmental science person, everything is about relationships, whether that's in the environment between plants and bacteria, or that's human-to-human relationships. All of those things make a system stronger. The more relationships you've got, the better your system, the stronger it will be. In the flower farming world, we have Facebook groups, we have text messages, or we just hang out together and we'd be like, what's the solution to this problem? I've got this pest. How do you deal with this kind of customer? What do you charge for this kind of bouquet, or whatever that is? It's like a background support network that the customer definitely doesn't see, but is a huge support to us farmers. I get like a whole supportive community. When I go to the farmers market, it's like going to a family. You get to see your customers, they're a family. You get to see the other farmers and other vendors who are not farmers, but they're your family too. They support you, they love you. All of those things are, I think, vitally important for a sustainable food system.